Hey everyone, it's Davi. In this video, we're gonna talking about JSF lifecycle and backing beam. I've already made a video showing how to create a JSF project using Eclipse IDE, and I use this project to showing the examples that I'm gonna talking about today. If we create a list of strings, for example, in our managed beam, when I will try add one element, it works. But when we try add another element, it doesn't work because the previous element, the first element, was deleted. It's because the default view scoped of the managed beam is request scoped. To solve this problem, we can use the view scoped. When I use the view scoped, this problem are solved. But there are another way to do it. We can use the session scope. When I use a session scope, I can access, I can see the data of the all of elements in the list in another tab of browser. But what difference between session scope and application scope? The difference is this. In the session scope, I can access these elements in the same browser. When I open my web application in another browser, I can access the another elements that I will add in the another browser. Application scoped, I share these data, these elements between two browsers. Is the difference between a session scoped and application scoped. In another video that I did, we saw that our integration between the managed bean and HTML elements. I can access the managed bean attributes and methods in the HTML element, but I can bring the HTML element and control it in within managed bean. It's called the backing bean. When I bring the HTML element and within managed bean and control it within managed bean. For example, I can disable a comment button when this list has the three elements. I can disable this comment button, for example. That's it, you guys. If you like it, don't forget to give it a thumb up and hit the subscribe button. Thanks for watching.